The Israelites complained against God and Moses,
becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross.
Because the cross is so important for us as Christians and Catholics, we look at it not only during Lent, but once again now in September on the 14th. I'd like to share with you an incident that happened to me this week, Thursday. I went shopping, and I was in the produce department, and I decided I'd like some fruits. One of the fruits I like are pineapples. So I went to the counter, and I'm looking over these pineapples, and alongside me is a cart with an infant, or let's say an 18-month-old, in the cart. And he's all excited about pineapples. I just couldn't figure out why somebody his age would be all excited, and he was mumbling. I couldn't understand his language. So I said to his mother, "What's this all about? How come he's all excited about pineapples?" She said, "Didn't you know that SpongeBob comes out of a pineapple?" I said, "No." And so I said to myself, you know, at my age, you can still learn, and at his age, he can already teach. So that's the youngest teacher I ever had, this 18-month-old. And I must remember now about SpongeBob and where he came from. Today I mentioned we must think about the Paschal mystery. Paschal refers to Easter. The mystery basically is God's tremendous love for us. We heard the words again, God so loved the world that he sent his only son to save the world. You see that at football games once in a while, that quote from John. You see it sometimes on bumper stickers. That's the saying. And it's probably sums it all up. God so loved the world. And we don't just simply stand in awe of that mystery. We should. But more than that, we should enter into that mystery. And the mystery simply is the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus. It doesn't end with his death. We move on to the resurrection. But we can't come to the resurrection unless we go through the experience of his death. Good Friday doesn't end there, but it'll lead us beyond that to Easter Sunday. So then, because the cross is so important for us as Christians and Catholics, we look at it not only during Lent, but once again now in September on the 14th, we have this wonderful feast called the Exaltation of the Cross, St. John's vision of Jesus as one who has triumphed, as one who has overcome death. What I'd like to do is just throw out three ideas based on that mystery. If we enter into it, what can we expect? If we embrace it, what should we look forward to? And so the first one is this. It gives us, when we think about his death and resurrection, it gives us an idea of the true meaning of life. It's so easy to live on the surface for many of us, and with superficialities and all the things that go on. But what is the true meaning of life? Why are we here? What's our purpose in life? And so this brings us back to the reality of what life is all about. It's not all joys. It's not all pleasures. It's not all happiness. We know that. There's a lot of suffering. There's a lot of sadness. There's a lot of pain. That, too, is part of the human experience. People have never asked me the question, you know, what is or how do I discover the cross of Jesus in my life? I've never been asked that question. But I have been asked the question, why is it that some people seem to have it so good? A lot of money, a lot of wealth, a lot of comforts, all that stuff. And I say to them, be careful, because you and I have no idea what goes on in the life of another person. No idea at all. So on the surface, it may seem that life is tranquil and everything's going just really well. But we don't know that. And they may be going through a very painful period in their lives. It isn't something that they share with others. So we have to be careful when we say that. The cross also is, someone said, a testing ground for virtues. Let's face it, we wouldn't be able to practice certain virtues if we didn't have the challenge that they bring. For example, in family life, the importance of patience, patience between spouses, patience between parents and their children, patience. We wouldn't have that if we didn't have all of the occasions which call forth for patience, or more importantly, forgiveness. If we have had a disagreement or an argument, that'll happen. We know that's part of life. But then how long does it take us to forgive and to forget and to begin all over again? or gratitude. It's so easy to take things for granted and to take time to step back, look at the gifts, and thank God. So there are so many challenges that come our way which enable us to practice the virtues. In other words, to become more virtuous people after the example of Jesus our Lord. And finally, the cross is something that leads up to hope. Hope in the midst of pain. You say, you know, where is the light at the end of the tunnel kind of thing? And again, we turn to our Lord and recognize what he's saying, that there is light at the end of the tunnel. Ultimately, of course, we're talking about our own death and resurrection. That's that ultimate hope. I mean, what is life all about if it isn't for the fact that we're going to live beyond this life? The old song, "What's It All About, Elfie?" Remember that? There are many people that don't have that hope, and they have to live with emptiness and despair. That's a terrible, terrible existence. And so the cross then, as we contemplate upon it, it can be as pain and suffering and brokenness as it was for Jesus, but we know what it leads to, and that is the resurrection of our Lord and the promise of our own resurrection. And so it's because of this promise then that we are a people of joy, and we are a people of peace no matter what. Something that's deep within us that nobody can take from us, no matter what's happening. Down deep, we are still a people of peace and joy. So I come back to what I said before. We're here to rejoice over this great back to the cross and what that means in our lives as individuals, and also to recommit ourselves to this Paschal mystery, the life, the death, and the resurrection of Jesus.